our next speaker is somebody else who has some really important information and has been, again, on behind the scenes of the front lines for a very long time. She's a former research scientist for the State Immunization Branch of the California Department of Health. Please welcome a beautiful and powerful, truthful voice, Tina Kimmel, PhD.
My name is Tina Kimmel. I was a research scientist for the California Department of Public Health until I retired a few years ago. I worked for the Immunization Branch from 1993-96. Prior to working at the Immunization Branch, I worked at the California Refugee Health Program. This is important because among other projects there, I kept track of the hepatitis B vaccines which were given to some newborns in families of refugees who were from countries where Hep B is endemic, right? This program worked fine because, you know, perinatal transmission. But when I transferred to the Immunization Branch in 1990, there were about half as many vaccines as there are now, and Hep B was not one of them. Now, here's my interesting story. At that time, the Immunization Branch would circulate publications of interest among the staff. One such publication was a vaccine industry newsletter. One day, I remember reading a headline, Hep B, largest profit ever. This really struck me because, naively, I thought, I didn't realize there was profit involved in the manufacture of vaccines because it's a public health good. Then, suddenly, a few months later, after that headline appeared at the end of 91, we were told by CDC that they were adding Hep B to the pediatric vaccine schedules, which now is required, as you know. Now, every baby in California had to get the series of Hep B vaccines, not just refugees. Everyone in the branch was stunned by this news, including the MDs. And you gotta understand how unusual that was. They were all very pro-vaccine, but this was over the line, even for the people in the branch. We only knew that Hep B was a disease spread in the U.S., primarily through unsafe sex and intravenous drugs. So the disease was almost unknown among young, non-immigrant children in California. At that time, there were about 75 cases a year in young children and falling like crazy. Now it's like two. We knew we would be giving three doses each to a half a million children a year. We knew that even if Hep B has a relatively low rate of morbidity, nobody really knew at that time, from the vaccine itself, it was likely to cause far greater morbidity than any disease it might prevent. We knew that from the get-go. But we were powerless to stop this worrisome, pointless, and expensive mandate, which apparently was driven by pharmaceutical profits through corruption of the CDC. Yeah. I mean, what other explanation is there? Luckily, however, parents were then, as they are still today, required to give their informed consent before each vaccination. So they had an opportunity to educate themselves. If they decided their child was not at risk for disease, such as hepatitis B, and wished to avoid the risks inherent in that particular vaccine, then they could just decline it. Their child was then and is still today able to attend daycare school using the personal belief exemption for that one vaccine or others. Now, I also was ahead, while I was working there, for a couple of years I was ahead of the State of California Personal Belief Exemption Program. I answered questions from parents and school administrators. I also kept track of the number of parents taking the exemption. In those days, it was about 1% statewide, whereas about 2% now, not a big number. Under the Personal Belief Exemption Program, parents simply agree that their child will be excluded from school if there's ever an outbreak of a disease that he wasn't fully vaccinated for. Simple. So in my opinion, there's no emergency, there's no reason to eliminate this excellent and intelligent program. I just want to say I feel that the personal belief exemption program, the purpose of it is democracy, to let people have a say in issues that directly concern them and their families. Every day the news tells us that democracy is being lost. cannot afford to lose any more of it. Resist. Defeat.